Welcome to Chapter 9, Energy Balance and Obesity. In this first section, we'll be discussing going over the obesity statistics. What I'd like to do is start with some CDC data. So this is the Center for Disease Control, and their data mapping for the obesity prevalence in the United States. And you can see here as we're starting with 1985, and we can look at the white areas, which is just the lack of data, but then the light blue showing that the prevalence of obesity in these states is less than 10%. As we get to a little bit of the darker blue, not the real dark, but you can see that it's about 10 to 14% in these states. But you know, we don't have any of the states over 15%, and definitely no states over 30%. So this is back in 1985. Now I want you to start watching as I click through these slides to 1990, that we're starting to see almost all of the states now do have some obesity prevalence. One is that there's more data that's being collected, but also you can see the increase in obesity as well. Through here we start now, finally by 1995, we do have states that do have 15 to 19% of the population that is obese. And you can see mostly we go throughout the Midwest and then throughout the southern states. Now starting to get over 20% in those same states, with those other states catching up on the West Coast. Notice that Colorado kind of sits here about 10 to 14%. And this is in 2000, 2005. Now we're not seeing any blue. So hardly any of the states have less than 20% obesity rate. Now some of these southern states, over 30% of the population is obese. And the most recent data is actually only up to 2010, but look through these southern states here, obesity rates of greater than 30%. The 20 to 25% rate in through these western states, then kind of the Northwest and Midwest, and 25 to 29%. So this is one of amazing statistics over the past few decades. This has not been that long. 1985, I was a sophomore in high school, so this was missed the low-fat age, as we would call it, the low-fat period, right in the middle of the 80s. Now, why is obesity a problem? Why do we care if there's obesity? Well, we're going to discuss this in more detail later, but obesity is associated with a number of health problems. Dyslipidemia, which means abnormal blood lipids, hypertension, which is high blood pressure, type 2 diabetes, which we discussed earlier in our carbohydrate chapter, stroke and heart disease, gallbladder disease, osteoarthritis, sleep apnea, and respiratory problems. Now, this is data from the CDC, and we're looking at obesity rates, which we just saw, in comparison to diabetes. So look at the increase in the prevalence, increasing prevalence of diabetes, and how it correlates with the increase in obesity. Now, although it's not exact, you can see that some of the same states, these southern states, initially have a greater prevalence down and through here, obesity as related to the diabetes, with some of the same states that have a lower rates of prevalence of obesity also do with diabetes. So there's a direct correlation between obesity and diabetes. Now, what about the percent of Americans who are overweight now? We have about 30% of the population has a healthy weight, and we're going to discuss this later in the next section, exactly how we define a healthy weight. About 27% are overweight, with 35% obese. Then we have this extreme obesity, and then underweight. And actually, if we take the overweight, obese, and extreme obesity, and we kind of lump them all together, that's going to be 68% of our total population. 68%, so almost 70% is either overweight, obese, or extremely obese. Whereas only 30% are a healthy weight. That leaves us little sliver, you know, just a couple percent of people who are actually underweight. Now, next we'll talk about exactly why this is important and how we determine overweight and obesity. So this is the end of the first section.